Alexander's bishop, and his two companions were martyred for their faith in the early 3rd century. Today, as we celebrate St. Denis and his companions, we remember our call to continue to strive to live out our faith in all instances of our lives. As we come to once again unite ourselves with our loving God, let us then prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries by acknowledging our sins and asking the Lord for his forgiveness. You were sent to the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
He came to all sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
And you are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. O God, who sent St. Denis and his companions to preach your glory to the nations and strengthen them for their mission with the virtue of constancy in suffering, grant, we pray, that we may imitate them in the sustaining prosperity in this world and in being undaunted by any trial. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you, the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Joel. Thus says the Lord, let the nations bestir themselves and come up to the valley of Jehoshaphat, for there will I sit in judgment upon all the neighboring nations. Apply the sickle, for the harvest is ripe. Come and tread, for the winepress is full. The vats overflow, for great is their malice. Crowd upon crowd in the valley of decision. For near is the day of the Lord in the valley of decision. Sun and moon are darkened, and the stars withhold their brightness. The Lord roars from Zion, and from Jerusalem raises his voice. The heavens and the earth quake, but the Lord is a refuge to his people, a stronghold to the children of Israel. Then shall you know that I, the Lord, am your God, dwelling on Zion, my holy mountain. Jerusalem shall be holy, and strangers shall pass through her no more. And then, on that day, the mountains shall drip new wine, and the hills shall flow with milk. And the channels of Judah shall flow with water. A fountain shall issue from the house of the Lord to water the valley of Shittim. Egypt shall be a waste, and Edom a desert place, because of violence done to the people of Judah, because they shed innocent blood in their land. But Judah shall abide forever, and Jerusalem for all generations. I will avenge their blood, and not leave it unpunished. The Lord dwells in Zion. The word of the Lord. Rejoice in the Lord, you just. Justice and judgment are the foundation of his throne.
Rejoice in the Lord with trumpets.
The mountains melt like wax before the Lord of all the earth. The heavens proclaim his justice, and all people see his glory.
Rejoice in the Lord with trumpets.
Light dawns for the just, and gladness for the upright heart. Be glad in the Lord, you just, and give thanks to his holy name.
Rejoice in the Lord, with trumpets.
In our very short and succinct gospel today, we are reminded by Jesus of how we are called to be blessed, how we are called to share in the goodness of God. That we are blessed when we hear the word of God and the servant. And I'm sure all of us, at the bottom of our hearts, know that that is what we have to do. That we have to listen to God, and we have to open our hearts to hear his voice, then put into action, follow the path that God has invited us to walk. We also recognize how difficult and challenging that is, and many times in our lives. It's not always easy to hear the voice of God, especially in a world that is as loud and as noisy as it is, a world that constantly tries to invite us to walk away from God and to follow our own desires, to follow our own intentions, to pursue our own interests. That's why the importance of prayer, to come to a place of solitude, to a place of quiet, so that we can truly immerse ourselves in hearing and listening to the word of God. But then that next step of following, of putting that into action, of observing what it is that the Lord has invited us to do, to have the strength, the courage, the willpower to put into action what it is that God has invited us to do. That's the struggle for us each and every day of our lives, struggling and pursuing and endeavoring to find how we can put into action what it is that the Lord invites us to do. And though we may recognize that it is difficult, though we may recognize that it is challenging, we are lifted up by the examples that the church continues to give. Today, as we celebrate the memorial of St. Denis and his companions, we are reminded that nothing should ever get in the way of us putting into action the Lord has invited us to do. Not even suffering, not even death. St. Denis, the very first bishop of Paris, and his two companions, whom we celebrate today, were willing to give up their lives for the faith. We are blessed. We are blessed to live in a society enough where perhaps we don't have to suffer or face the same consequences of dying for our faith in a physical manner. But are we willing to die a spiritual death in which we give up of our own desires, in which we give up our own interests, so that we may truly listen to the voice of God and do what he asks of us. As we come to this Eucharist today, we come to hear the word of God. We come to unite ourselves with our Lord in spirit and communion. And we will be invited afterwards to then go out to share that good news with others. As we come to hear the word of God today, we come to receive the gifts that we need to observe what the Lord has asked us to do. Let us continue to help one another. Let us continue to support one another as a community of faith, to walk the ways of the Lord and continue to build God's kingdom on earth.
Blessed are you, Lord, out of all creation, for your goodness we have received the bread we offer you. Fruit of the earth, Lord, in your hands, become with us the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for your goodness we have received the wine we offer you. Food for the vine, Lord, in your hands, and become for us our spiritual drink. Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And
lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For you are glorified when your saints are praised. Their very sufferings are but wonders of your might. In your mercy, give ardor to their faith, to their endurance, to their firm resolve, and in their struggle, the victory is yours through Christ our Lord. Therefore, all creatures of heaven and earth sing a new song in adoration, and we, with all the hosts of angels, cry out, and without them, we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord.
In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
Look not on our sins, but on the
of your church, and graciously grant your peace even in accordance with your will, who let it reign forever and ever.
Amen.
Peace the Lord be with you always,
and with your spirit.
Let us offer each other and ourselves. Behold, the Lamb of God. Behold, Him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Let us pray. O God, who in your holy martyrs have wonderfully made known the mystery of the cross, graciously grant that drawing strength from this sacrifice, we may cling faithfully to Christ and labor in the church for the salvation of all, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.